Elon Musk and Stephen Hawking are among some of the scientists who have signed a letter urging researchers to calm down with artificial intelligence. They argue that artificial intelligence, and specifically autonomous weapons, could lead to the destruction of society as a whole. So let me give you an example of what the letter says. In a letter unveiled as researchers gathered at the International Joint Conference on Artificial Intelligence in Buenos Aires on Monday, the signatories argued that the development of robots capable of killing while untethered to human operators is feasible within years, not decades. If development is not cut off, it is only a matter of time before the weapons end up in the hands of terrorists and warlords, they said. Also, if any major military power pushes ahead with artificial intelligence, weapon development, a global arms race is virtually inevitable, and the end point of this technological trajectory is obvious. Autonomous weapons will become the Kalashnikovs of tomorrow.
This is super interesting to me. Yeah. I mean, these guys are not lightweights. This is not conspiracy theories. Elon Musk is not only the head of SpaceX, but also Tesla. He's the only guy, I believe, in America that has founded two different billion-dollar companies. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's amazing, let alone just the scientific breakthroughs that he comes out with. He says that artificial intelligence in this context is humanity's, quote, biggest existential threat. Okay, now Hawking, who's considered perhaps the smartest man alive, says that artificial intelligence could be the biggest breakthrough in human history, but, quote, unfortunately, it might also be the last. These are weighty, weighty statements. I'm almost can't believe how, you know, out there these statements are, but these are no dummies. They're smarter than we are, right?
Right.
And they're not alone. Let me give you a bit more of the signatories. Steve Wozniak, co-founder of Apple, Noam Chomsky, Demis Hassabis, who's the chief executive of artificial intelligence company, Google DeepMind.
So even he signed this, which is incredible. But I wonder if he signed it because of monopoly reasons. I don't know, whatever. I don't know what his intentions are. Who cares? Who cares? But what I want to do real quickly is just differentiate between the use of things like drones and autonomous weaponry. So with autonomous weaponry, it's not attached to a human being at all, okay? It's mm-hmm. autonomous. So with drones, we already have an issue with, you know, killing people being less personal. You're in a remote location, you use a drone, and boom, they're being overutilized. Innocent people are dying as a result of that. If you have autonomous weaponry, there are no people attached to it at all, which takes the morality out of something as serious as killing someone.
We can't have it. It's they're absolutely right. That part of it is crazy talk. Look, if you're talking about artificial intelligence and they're, you know, cleaning your house, or, of course, the military says is first they're going to go search for bombs so that a person isn't killed. That sounds great. We all say yes, but that's first. And I did a story about how they had, at the time, Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel, they did this public thing, the U.S. military, and they show you how the robot can go defuse the bomb. And then they said, now, for the secret portion, we'll take the Defense Secretary back where there are no reporters. And then they show them how the robots can kill people, right? So, now look, it's behind closed doors. There was some assumptions made in that earlier report, but I think they're wholly merited, and these guys think they're wholly merited. So separate out the non-killing robots from the killing robots that are not attached to human beings. You've got to be against that. You've got to be. I mean, so we're saying, now right now there's a guy in Tampa that operates the drone, and oftentimes they have sketchy intelligence. They call it signal intelligence. So there's not a guy on the ground saying, oh, I see, you know, Mullah Omar, okay, go ahead and drop the bomb. They say, oh, there's a cell phone that Mullah Omar once used. We've detected that on the ground. Who's holding the cell phone now? I don't know. But at least there's a human being who presses the button.
Right.
In the new autonomous robots that are literally, in that case, would be killing machines, there's no, as Anna said, there's no morality. There's no one to check. They just go, I have located this piece of hardware, or I have located X or Y or Z in whatever mechanical computation that they made. They press the button on their own.
Yes.
We can't have that. That's crazy.
I think with all technology, you have to do a cost-benefit analysis, right? So with all technology that's been developed thus far, there has been a lot of great things that came out of it and also a lot of abuse. So something like the internet, for instance, a lot of great things came out of the internet, a lot of abuse as well. But I think the costs are not as bad as the benefits, right? But at the same time, with something like autonomous weaponry and artificial intelligence, I feel like the downsides are more significant than the upsides, right? Because let's say you even take the killing part out of it and you look at the more benign part of it, I guess. I mean, artificial intelligence, what, we're going to have robots taking our jobs too? Like, that would be disastrous as well.
So, well, to some degree, that already happens.
Right.
And certainly will happen more. There's no question about that. But look, if you program the robot to eliminate threats, what if you decide to shut the robot down and it detects a threat? Mm-hmm. Well, you would be threatening it. I mean, I hope that you wrote the program in a way that it doesn't view you as a threat. I know now we're getting into a little bit of science fiction. But again, the smartest people on the planet are telling you it's not really science fiction. Like, once they have actual artificial intelligence, we don't really know what's going to happen next. And that's pretty scary.
So let's end on that note.
Okay. If you thought our human cops were bad, wait till you get a load of RoboCop.